In a real sales presentation, in addition to showing the total annual sales for each location, you will probably want to show a breakdown of the sales, for example, which item sold the most, the total sales for each month, and so on. And that is exactly what we are going to do in this tutorial. Let's begin by drawing a rectangle to cover the slide. The rectangle should be at least 80 centimeters wide and approximately 40 centimeters tall. Perfect. I believe we can work with this. Before proceeding, let's open Shape Outline and click on No Outline. Then open Shape Fill and select Black Color. The reason we choose black color is because we want to create a spotlight effect, and to achieve that, we have to first click on Oval Shape, hold down Shift key, and draw a perfect circle. Now we can remove the outline of the circle. To visualize how and where to position the circle, we need to increase the transparency of the rectangle. I'll increase its transparency to about 65%. Awesome! Now we can see the map. Let's zoom in and move the circle to this position. Now let's resize the circle and position it over the area corresponding to New York. Meanwhile, we can also decrease the transparency of the circle. Zoom in and resize the circle. Fantastic! This is where it starts getting more interesting. I'll close Format Shape Pane and zoom out. Then click on the rectangle, hold down Shift key and select the circle. Head over to Mesh Shapes and click on Subtract. This action creates a hole in the rectangle, which is important for the next step. Now we have to click on the rectangle and move it such that the circle is outside the slide. Once that is done, let's open Format Shape and increase the transparency of the rectangle to 100%. You will soon understand why we are doing this. Okay, it may seem like the rectangle is no longer there, but trust me, it's still present. Okay, pay attention because this is where the fun part begins. First, let's right-click on this slide and duplicate it. On the new slide, I'll select the rectangle, open Format Shape, and reduce its transparency to 13%. Now we can move the empty part of the rectangle to the first cell's location, New York. Let's zoom in for a better view and ensure the callout shape is in the center of the circle. Now let's go to Transitions tab and select Morph. Then reduce its duration to 1 second. Let's run slideshow and see the results so far. On the first slide, nothing happens. But as we move to the next slide, it creates a spotlight effect and highlights the first location, which if you ask me, I think it's pretty cool. Now we can use this slide as a template for other locations. But before that, let's open Shape Format and decrease the transparency just a little bit more. When we run slideshow, you can see it's difficult to see other locations because we want the focus to be on one location at a time. Moving forward, let's right-click on slide 2 and duplicate it. Zoom in and move the spotlight to the second location, Rio. To cover all 6 locations, we just have to repeat the same steps, but I'm not going to bore you with that. Instead, let's skip to the last location. I'm going to duplicate this slide and move the spotlight to Sydney. Now let's see the results by running slideshow. First, we see all 6 locations across the globe. Then we drill down to individual locations, from New York to Rio, then London to Dubai, to Tokyo, and finally to Sydney. This looks awesome, but in most sales presentation, you'll be expected to provide a breakdown of the total sales, and we are going to do that with a little bit of finesse by adding some interactivity to this presentation. So are you ready? Alright, first, let's head over to slide 2, like our lives depends on it. Right-click and select Copy. I'll close the main section, open the details section, and just below the section title, I'll click and paste the slide. Before we continue, let's get rid of its transition because we don't need it. Below this slide are four other slides with column graph that I created for this part of the tutorial. I used lines, rectangles, and text to create this graph, pretty standard. Let's cut and paste it on the first slide under this section, the one for New York. I'll press down Shift key, reduce its size, and move it over here. On this graph, I have applied three animations. The first one is the fade animation. The second one is grow shrink. Its size is 125%, a duration of 0.01 seconds, and it starts with previous. The last one is still grow shrink with a size of 80%. Smooth end is 0.75 seconds, a duration of 0.75, and it starts with previous as well. Our goal right now is to create a connection between this detail slide and the one for New York. In other words, when you are on this slide and you click on the location, it should take you to the slide with the column graph. And when you click on this X icon, it should take you back to the previous slide. Basically, that's the game plan. So let's select the graph. Go to Insert and click on Action. By default, mouse click is selected. Click on Hyperlink 2. Open the drop down and select Slide. I'll click on slide 2 because we want it to take us back to the slide for New York. Click OK, then check I liked click and OK to apply the action. Remember, we want this navigation to occur both ways. So let's go to slide 2 and create a link to slide 9. First, I'll select the callout shape and open action. Check hyperlink 2, open the drop down. Click on slide and select slide number 9. And of course, let's highlight the click and then OK to apply. Now let's take it for a spin and see if it will work as expected. Fingers crossed. So here we are on the first slide. Then we move to the first location. Now I expect that when I click on it, the graph should zoom in, and it did. If we click on the X icon or anywhere on the graph, it takes us back to the previous slide. And that allows us to move to the next location. If you did not get that the first time, don't worry because we are going to repeat it for the second location. So first, let's go to slide 3, which is for Rio. Right click and copy it. Then move down to detail section. Let's delete this empty slide and paste the one we just copied. Below it is the graph for Rio de Janeiro. Cut and paste it on slide 10. Let's resize and position it in the top right corner. We forgot to remove its transition, but no worries, let's do that right away. Now select the graph, go to Insert and click on Action. Make sure it's on mouse click. Select Hyperlink 2, open its drop down and click on Slide. From the window, select slide 3, which is for Rio de Janeiro, and click OK. Check I liked click and OK to apply. Now we have to go to slide 3 and add mouse click action back to slide 10. I'll select the callout and click on action. We're just going to apply the same settings. The only difference is we are linking this action to slide 10. When we run slideshow and move to New York, we click to see more detail. As we click to close the graph, it takes us back to the previous slide. Then we move to the next location, click on the callout, and voila! The graph appears. Once we are done, we can close and move to the next location, and so on. This was a lot, but I hope it's worth every minute of your time. If you want this template, just email salespt to hello@incrediskill.com and I will send it to you. Watch out for my next tutorial because it's going to be intriguing.